Skirt, skirt on niggas. Skirt, skirt on these bitches. Yeah. Skirt down and they do it for free. Girl, you know we wasn't more than.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna do a chit chat. Get ready with me. Now, let me just be honest with y'all. I tried to record this video yesterday, which is when I actually was going out and doing something, but I looked back at the footage today and I didn't like what I saw. So, I'm not about to give y'all no half filmed or half, I don't want to say the curse word because it's a lot of people, you know, kids watch them. Whatever, y'all get what I was saying. I ain't like it. So, I'm going to record it again for you guys. I'm going to put the same outfit on and everything just so you guys can see what I was wearing in case you didn't see it on my Instagram already. So, yeah, let's just get right into the video and let's get to talking. So, first, I'm going to pin my hair back because all this hair in my face is not cutting it right now. Oh, y'all probably see. Oh, yeah. Please don't get annoyed. This is my mirror right here. I need my mirror. If I put it here, that's kind of annoying. Is it annoying or should I keep it on the side? I'm going to just keep it right here. Whatever. So, I'm just going to clip my hair back. Most of you guys already know that this hair is from my collection, which is going to be launching very soon. I hate when I get to talking like that. Like, y'all some little kids or something. Anyways, yeah, so my hair is going to be launched very soon. There's a lot of time and, you know, it's just a process. It's a very long process, but I'm getting it done slowly but surely. I ain't do my edges either, so if y'all see my edges, then be like, look, I'm sorry. Oh, by the way, this is not a tutorial either, so I hope you guys don't expect me to be like, and this is, I'm not doing that today. I'm so sorry. But if y'all ask the question, I'll answer it in the comments. But other than that, I'm probably just going to go as I told. So, yeah. Anyways, I'm kind of annoyed a little bit because my eyebrows aren't done. And when my eyebrows aren't done, I feel very ugly. I know I'm not the only person out there who hates that. I cannot stand when my brows aren't done. They're so bushy. I'm just happy I don't grow a unibrow. No shade out there to, you know, you people who grow unibrows or whatever. I just wouldn't like that. So, yeah, and it's just very annoying. But what we're going to do right now is we're going to make some new brows because y'all know brows are my specialty. Well, my brows. Sometimes other people, but y'all know what I'm talking about. I was so weak because some people might notice, so I'm just going to talk about it. I used a actual pencil sharpener to sharpen my eyebrow pencil because I'm lazy. And some people might really think that I'm sitting here doing my eyes with a real pencil. And my nail broke too, by the way. I'm just all over the place right now. So please forgive me. Anyway, so I know most of you guys probably heard or maybe this is the exact reason why you shouldn't. Wow. Very childish. Let me find a sharpener. All right, time. I usually have pencil sharpeners everywhere. It's probably at the bottom. Oh, well, I'm just going to do my brow anyway. Clean that right up. Yeah, I'm about to create a whole new brow, so let me show you right now what my brow looks like. Y'all see that? Not cute, so we about to fix that on up right now. I know most of y'all already saw, like, on social media and stuff, Kylie Jenner had her baby, and it was just so cute. Wait, I can't make expressions. Hold on. But, yeah, it was just so cute. Like, I don't know. I'm so sensitive, so I just was watching a video like Shania. You're not about to cry, like, not today. But it was so hard because it was just so beautiful. And, you know, a lot of people always have their opinions about, you know, her birth and her keeping it a secret. But I don't blame her because, look, being in the limelight is really not that easy. I'm not, like, as big as her, but I do know that publicity and all types of, like, attention is not good attention. And it could be very overwhelming because, you know, sometimes you don't even have to do anything bad for someone to say something negative about you. Like, first of all, people are going to say negative things about you all the time anyway. One second. Yeah, I'm going to have to resharpen this. But, yeah, all attention is not good attention. And once again, people are going to have something negative to say regardless, whether you're doing something good or bad. And I really hate that about people. Like, why must you take time out of your day to say something negative about me. I'm not even worried about you, sis. Like, or bro. Well, any guy that just critiques women on their free time is a sis to me. I don't care. Did this... Yo! They don't want to... They don't want to see me win. They don't want to see me win. But yeah. People... Like, yeah, so any guy that could just sit around and just judge women all day is really a sis. Like, you're mad feminine for that. And I hate a guy who's, you know, always in a mix-up or always got to say, like, their two cents or judge. Because 9 times out of 10, you don't got your life together either. You're sitting on your phone critiquing me when you could be doing something productive with your life. So clearly, my life is more important than yours if you feel like you could sit there and judge me. You know what I'm saying? It's just very corny. But yeah, it's just very corny and unattractive to me. I can't stand it. But anyways, I don't know if you guys watched the video already, but that video was just so beautiful. Like, that's kind of how I want to do my pregnancy. And not just because Kylie did it, but I like documenting my life. I like looking back on memories and seeing, like, how much I've grown over the years. And, you know, just reminiscing on memories. I've always been like that. Like, you can ask my friends. You can ask my family. Like, that's what I do. I record and take pictures. Well, I don't really take pictures that much, but I definitely do try to record, like, all my family and friends' moments. It's just, like, when you look back, you'll be like, oh, like, I remember this or remember that, or I can't wait to do this again. And it, like, it gives you motivation because it's like, if I was there, and it could be bad. Well, I don't usually, like, record bad moments, but you can reminisce on a moment or whatever. You may look like you're happy or you was having fun or whatever the case may be, but only you know where you was at mentally in that video or in that picture. You know what I'm saying? So it's like you teach yourself, kind of like, if I was so sad in this picture, but if I was pretending to be happy, but I was really, you know, sad or whatever the case may be in that situation, and then you think about where you are now, like, wow, I've really changed. I'm more happy with myself, my surroundings, etc. It really gives you motivation. And self-motivation is the best motivation you could give. Because let me tell you, y'all can't depend on people to be our motivation all the time. Because it's like, it's not their job. And when they're not there, and that's exactly how I look at things now, too. Like, when you're not here, who am I going to turn to? You understand? Not necessarily saying nobody's there for you or whatever the case may be, but you're not here, so I got to make it happen for myself. It's reality. Like, you know what I'm saying? I can't, and I'm a very independent person. If you really know me, you know I'm very independent. And if I need something to get done, I will get it done right by myself because I don't need nobody. And there's a lot of people who scream they don't need nobody when they really need somebody. But I feel like I've been through that stage. Like, I don't need nobody. I'm going to get it done. I'm going to make it happen by myself. That's why I feel like I've made it so far. And it's like, it seems like it's been so far, but this is really just the beginning. Like, and I can't wait to see where I'm going to be next year, 5 years from now, 10 years from now. Like, I got faith in myself. So, you know, I'm not really worried about it too much. But yeah, so congratulations to Kylie. Hold on, y'all. I can't talk while I do my brows, so give me a second. Okay, I'm back. I had to finish my eyebrows off camera. You already know my camera be overheating and stuff like that. So, yeah. Anyways, so we're back in action with the good brows. Good eyebrows is key to a good makeup look. I'm telling y'all right now. I'm going to put some Vaseline on my lips. I forgot what I was talking about. I hate when that happens. But, yeah. I don't know. It's just a sick world we live in. People are going to be jealous of you for no reason all the time. And it's going to happen regardless. So I hope none of you guys are stressing over it or trying to please everybody or get really upset when they hear a lot of negative opinions, whatever the case may be. Look, we don't got time for all that negativity. You could just block it out your life or learn how to ignore it. Because I really learned how to deal with negativity and, you know, people trying to get clout off your name. Like, I've dealt with that so many times. It's just like, I just toss it. It's just like, I just toss it over there. Like, I don't have time for that. Like, I'm trying to live my life, trying to be positive, you know, trying to look cute, get my way, you know, do my thing. I stay out of the drama. That's one thing a lot of people could say about me. I stay out of the drama. I am drama free. I cannot stand it. It's just, I'm too old for that. Like, Yeah, I know I'm only 20, but I'm too old for that. Like, ew, I'm 20. Oh, my God. I'm 20. Oh. You know what? Whatever. Anyway. These brows are something serious. Wet lace. Got a closure on. All of this stuff right there. My little ass eyelashes. Yeah, enough with that though. Just, y'all already know how it goes. Like, don't entertain negative drama. Don't entertain drama, period. Because it's annoying. Like, unnecessary drama is very annoying. I've been over that whole stage. Like, I don't, like, nobody drag me into no drama. I don't care who you are. But, yeah. Yeah, I've been breaking out so much lately. I just don't, you know what it is? I think it's the food I've been eating. I've been eating a lot of fatty foods. And I realize now, I didn't think it would have a toll on my skin. But clearly, as some of y'all could probably see, well, I don't know. Well, when I zoomed in, you probably saw, like, I was breaking out my forehead. But I'm breaking out so bad. It's the most annoying thing ever, I swear. And it's like, how could you eat the things that you like without your body or your skin reacting negatively to it? I'm trying to, like, eat more healthy and, you know, cook inside my house and everything like that. But I want food and I want it now. So, I don't know. I'm so, that impediment I'm taking got me so hungry all the time. It's ridiculous. Like, I feel like I spend at least $10 to $20 on food every time I eat out. That's not good. I look like I came from some type of tribe. All right, stop. Anyways. But yeah, you know another thing I realized too, talking back about the Kim Kardashian thing? There were so many rumors about how she was depressed. Well, we never know if she was depressed, but it don't look like it now. We saw the documentary, but she's so depressed and single. She's going to be a single mother. And how, what else was they saying? Oh, yeah, she's going to be a single mother and Travis left her, etc. Just making up all different types of stuff. And I'm like, yo, that's one thing I fear. If I become a celebrity, I would hate for the tabloids and TMZ and all these fake websites to just be making up anything about me. Don't get me wrong. It's like, you know what you're doing. So it's like, don't worry about it. But at the same time, it's like, you cannot explain that to millions of people. Because you know, some people just really don't want to see you in any way. So they would love for you to be going through stuff. Which is really disgusting and it's really horrible. I look all crazy, but I didn't even prime my face. Wow. I did not prime my face. Don't you hate when you... I know, yeah, like I was saying, some people may be, like, trained to deal with stuff like that. Or they're just so used to it, they just don't care anymore. But it's just very annoying. And it's honestly very annoying to see. Because it's like, obviously, I don't know what might be really going on with them. I just got to... David, oh, this is a mess. But I'm on. I don't care. I gotta get that primer. Just use my. Oh, my hands are not even. Whatever. But I just hope I'm as strong. Well, I know I will be because I'm kind of used to it already myself. So I kind of just ignore negativity, even though it may get to me sometimes. But that's another thing. Y'all and myself, because I don't want to sit here and preach like I'm perfect. We have to know when to and when not to put our energy in certain things. Because certain things, they just don't deserve your energy. They just really don't. And it's a waste of time for the most part. It's really disgusting. I'm over it. But honestly, I was just so... It's just so... Like, I don't know, I hope that, because a lot of people may wonder, like, if I get into a relationship in the future, like, would I be, you know, putting him on my social media, on my channel, etc. And don't get me wrong, I love things like that. I love showing off my partner. I love all that lovey-dovey stuff, you know. I watch my De'Aaron, Ken, and Gold Juice, and, you know, all of them. And it's so funny, because, by the way, the girl, Olivia, from, Gold Juice, I used to go to school with her. It's just so fun. Well, it's just so weird seeing somebody, like, basically famous and knowing that you used to go to school with them and, like, see them every day. It's just like, oh, my God. It's inspiring, too, because it's like, look, if they could do it, I definitely could do it. Like, I know we all get like that. It just looks so exciting, like, and I cannot wait until, you know, that's another thing, guys. If y'all going to talk with me, I talk all over the place. Like, I talk about from one topic to another, then I start a whole new conversation. I'm so sorry if some of y'all think that's annoying. But just bear with me. It's my first chit-chat get ready with me. And I'm trying. So, I'm going to just start buffing up my foundation. But, yeah, so, back to what I was saying. I'm so sorry. I keep jumping from topic to topic. But, yeah, I feel like eventually I just might, but as of right now, I wouldn't even be able to tell you guys a solid answer, because as of now, I'm so big on privacy and, you know, not having everybody in my business, because it's like, once you let people into your world, you have all these stories and, oh, he this, oh, she that, like, please. Like, please, I don't want to hear it. Like, do you want to see me win, or do you just want to give me a reason to be upset or let that person go? Sometimes people do that stuff like that because they want the person that you're with. And it's very sick, and it's not cute at all. And they be dread when you still with the person. Why they be girl, they be dread. Oh, if you don't know what that means, dread is like they feel very stupid. They feel like, it's like, yeah, that's basically what it is. They just feel very dumb. And they probably wish they didn't even say anything. And they feel very stupid. And it's like, good for you, because you should have minded your business. Like, stay in the going for, stay in the chat's place. Stay in the chat's place, girl. So, yeah. I don't know, maybe one day. I'm not saying no, but I'm not saying yes as of yet. Because know how things and people are. It's getting all into my hairline. All on my hair. And this foundation is coming off very yellow. But it's gonna oxidize very soon. I use this foundation all the time and I don't have any issues with it. So, stay tuned. And I'm cheap, so I'm about to scrape the rest of this foundation right up in this bottle. We ain't gonna waste over here. Alright, so let me do my highlight. But yeah, so, I don't know. That's something I'm really gonna have to think about. I know some of y'all probably watching this like, yo, she's babbling. I'm so sorry. You gotta get the peoples what they want. I know some of y'all be giving me all these new ideas, so, and I definitely appreciate that and take them into consideration. I'm trying to be more consistent with my videos, as y'all can see. I feel like I've improved from a couple of months ago, because before when I was doing my videos, I was probably uploading like once a month, if that. I don't want to do that anymore. I like interacting with you guys. I like when y'all comment on my stuff. I like all that good stuff. So definitely keep it coming. It motivates me to do more. And all the people who send me, it mostly comes from Snapchat. But when you guys send me paragraphs about how you're so proud of me and you can't wait till I make it really big, etc. Y'all don't know how much that means to me, because Lord knows. Sometimes I just be like, I don't even want to do this no more. And I'm like, what? Why would you not want to, like, what? I feel like this is made for me. Like, this is my kind of lifestyle. I like doing things like this. I'm just getting used to it, being that I just started not too long ago. You know what I'm saying? But I hate when I start thinking all negative. Like, why would I not want to do this? Like, give it a good reason. And that's another thing. With this whole entrepreneur, business owner thing, when I tell you, it gets so overwhelming sometimes. You just really don't understand. It's so, like, I can't even, and it makes you want to quit sometimes. But it's like, besides me being my biggest motivation, my father is definitely one of my biggest, like, motivations. Because he's like, no, you're going to get it right. And my dad, he's not the sympathetic type. So he'll just tell me how it is from right from there. And he'll keep walking. Like, and it's like, sometimes you need that tough love. Because I know I'm very sensitive. So I can't have some. Like, sometimes I do want somebody to, not baby me, but kind of tell me what it is, but in a nice, soft way. But sometimes you gotta hear it in the aggressive way. Because you gotta know, there's no games that need to be played here. Like, you need to get to it, and you need to get to it now. And don't stop until you make it. And I love things like that. That's partially why I like talking to my dad sometimes. Don't get me wrong. Sometimes I talk to my dad like, yo, I wish he was more sensitive. But then again, it's like, sometimes you don't need somebody to baby you. Because it's like, how are you gonna be ready for the real world? Like, how are you gonna know when you really get out there? And like, how are you, like, how can I put it, just basically that, like, how are you gonna be ready for the real world? Because your dad or your parents or whoever motivates you, they're not gonna be there for you when times get hard, when you're older. It's all you, and that's the point, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you gotta be ready for what this world has to offer. And there could be some real cruel people out there, and it could make you so emotional and make you want to give up, and you know, all that negative stuff. But I can't go out like that. I can't. Like, that's one thing I know about myself. I don't care how discouraged I may get sometimes, I will never let anybody's words or whatever the case may be stop me from what I'm doing. Like, I was never that type of person. And for anything, if somebody's trying to bring me down, I'm gonna take that and run with it. You know what I'm saying? I was never the type to be like, oh, it said I couldn't do it, so I just don't think this is for me. Never. 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 Y'all hear me? Never. That was never me. I could never be that type of person either. Because it's like, you gonna really sit there and let a person tell you what you can and you cannot do? Are you kidding me? And I cannot stand people like that either. Because, oh my God, like, you really just gonna sit there and let people tell you what you can and cannot do? You just need to learn from that and prosper from it. Like, you know what? Use that as motivation. Be like, you know what? They said I couldn't do it, so let me show them how good I can do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I probably didn't say you know what I'm saying mad times already. So I'm just gonna bake under my contour and lightly bake under my eyes, because I don't want a cakey look. Because some people really over bake, and it's like, girl, take that off. You look dumb. You look very dumb and cakey. You don't want that. Okay guys, so I'm back once again. Don't remember what I was talking about. Once again, I'm over it. But at least I got food. Got my Tyson buffalo. What is this? I think it's buffalo strips. I don't know. So good. I did my face, my eyes, etc. I do my lips now. I use, honestly, a couple of lip combos. Honestly, anything with color pretty much works for me. I mean, not color. Anything neutral works for me is what I meant. Once again, this is not a tutorial, but some people may want to know. So, all I'm going to do is take this regular lip liner I got from the hair store. Fill it in. I'm just all over the place today, to be honest. Okay, I don't know how I'm gonna do this and eat, but I'm gonna find a way. Then I think I put the lip thing in the bag, but it's right here. What color is this? Blankety by MAC. It's like a neutral pinkish color. Definitely one of my favorites. I think I'm gonna do a 2017-2018 favorites, because I've been kind of using the same things. So I'm gonna do that for y'all. Rub that in a little bit. I don't take it all the way to the top. I just kind of then rub my lips in together. Just like that. It looks kind of crazy, but that's when I go back in with my pencil. We don't want to be out here looking like a crackhead. Then I take, well, now I just started doing this. Now, usually you guys will see me using Praline or Praline, the butter, what is this? Butter gloss, my NYX, or NYX, whatever. But I don't, am I gonna, actually, I think I might use a little bit of it today. Okay, so I'm gonna put Lust Gloss, it's a neutral color, by MAC on my bottom lip and rub it in. Then I'm gonna take same butter gloss, because this is really my go-to favorite lip gloss. Oh, it brings some color back to my lips. I love it. And it has like a plumish, pinkish kind of look to it. I soon zoom in so you guys can see what I'm talking about. And then I'm gonna take Viva Glam Taraji P. Henson. That's what it says. This is like a glittery lip gloss. She had a collection with MAC. And one day I just went and picked it up. It's like a gold sparkle kind of look. I just think all of these together look so bomb. I try not to put too much, but I can't help it. See, once you get that line, I don't like it, because once you talk, it like slimes. Ugh. I hate when people do that. I just be like, girl, she's gonna take a napkin. There we go. Better. Let me zoom in a little bit. Okay. Yeah, no, I'm extra, so I'm gonna just put a little bit more highlight. I'm gonna use my Master Chrome. And being that I already used a lot, I'm just gonna take a little bit. Go over that. I don't even have to say anything. You already see it. Now, let me just take one more bite of my chicken. Okay, so now we're all done with the makeup. So now, I'm about to go change my clothes and I'll be right back.
I wanna be with you.